everyone, welcome back to episode 4, the best swing trade pattern for mornings. I'm lead trainer with Stocks to Trade, Tim Bowen. If you're stumbling on this video out of sequence, definitely head over to stockstotrade.com/free training. You'll get the worksheet, you'll also get the archive. Obviously, this is episode 4. I'm glad you're here. I would prefer you start at the beginning and work your way through. And again, if you go to the free training link below and stockstotrade.com/free training, you'll be able to catch up, you'll get the worksheet, etc. All right, that being said, let's talk about the best swing trade pattern for mornings, okay? And that is gonna be the week open red to green, okay? And let me define a couple terms. This can be confusing to people because of a lot of the commonality of words and stuff. So when I say week open, it's W-E-A-K, like weak, like you can't pick up much weight, like a weak chart that can't go higher. A lot of people get confused because they're thinking time frames, which is good. You know, we talk about daily, weekly, monthly, yearly patterns on the chart. But when I say week open, I'm talking about W-E-A-K, which is a stock that basically a red open. You know, you could say the same thing. You could see a red open, red to green, which is a little redundant. But so that's that weak idea. It's a stock that's been steadily uptrending for days. Okay, you can see DATS. I'm going to jump back to today's action. But you can see DATS has 7 green days in a row. Going back to today would have been 6 green days. Today was the 7th. But it's a stock that is steadily uptrending. At 52-week highs, go back to your worksheet, it closes near the high of the day, which is what we want, because now we've got a bullish chart on the daily as well as the intraday chart. So we've got that time frame alignment. So the idea is very strong close on the daily chart and the intraday. Well, how do we enter this stock? Do we just do a market order in the morning, pile in? You know, how do we actually approach this thing? What we want and what we love about that week open red to green is its confirmation, okay? And when I say red to green, green to red, that is based on the previous day's close, okay? So anytime you hear me say red to green to red, it is that previous day's indicator, which you can see is denoted on my screen as this yellow line. And the reason it's called the green to red is if the stock is below the closing day's or previous day's price, is red on the day. If it's above the previous day's close, it's called green on the day. So the idea is the stock steadily uptrending for days, weeks, months. I mean, this is all time highs for DATS. Then it opens red, which you're looking for buyers to step in and support. And you can see that happen this morning. DATS, you know, had a little bit of a gap up, but pretty weak, but then went red on the day at about 10:45 a.m. and then basically stayed red all the way up until 1:30 in the afternoon. Now, I know I'm calling this the best morning pattern, but this is just such a great example. Normally we would look at a red to green a little earlier in the day. Focus on the pattern more than the time of day in this example. This is just such a beautiful example. I had to use it today, but normally they'll gap down at the open, then go green in that 9:45 window, which you hear me talk about all the time, whether it be in the ebook, the podcast, pre-market prep, etc. So once that stock goes green, that's showing us that the buyers are still in control. They push that stock higher through the high or through that green to red, red to green, sorry. And then that shows up on everybody's scanners. It's a new 52-week high because remember now we're above the previous day's close and you can see the volume confirmation come in. So now we're looking at that whole dollar, half dollar. We talked about again in the previous video, this would have been 12. So when 12 breaks, you risk off of green to red. So you'd be risking down at 11.50. That gives you a goal of 13.50, 3-to-1 risk to reward, something you'll hear me talk about all the way through this course. Once it breaks 12, you'd use your stop limit order that we talk about as our way to automate this in future videos. You would set your stop order at 12.50, you would set your goal at 13.50, and you can see at about an hour later, you would have been filled at 13.50, you would have made $1.50 a share, risking 50 cents a share in a quote unquote quality, hot sector, earnings winner, stock. I mean, this thing is, again, very, very good setup. And ultimately, it's the same thing tomorrow. You know, tomorrow, because you can see, notice, going back to the beginning of the video, pay attention to what I said, it now closed literally at the high of the day. I mean, it pinned the high of the day at 1460-ish, which is also a new 52-week high, which is also, then tomorrow, the red to green to red line is gonna be 1460. We're gonna look for that week open, which you can see is gapping down in after hours, probably key off of the 15 level, and we'd have a 3-to-1 risk to reward, probably up into the high teens, as high as 20, while risking probably a dollar a share down in the 13 area, all right? So that being said, I know I went fast, I know I talked fast, but I wanna jam as much content in here as possible. Feel free to rewatch the video, but understand, the biggest things I'm, just to review, biggest things you're looking for, that box checker, okay, that checks to all the boxes, other than that neutral on the good company, closes at 52s, okay, closes at 52s, closes near the high of the day, then gaps down and goes green in the morning. That is one of the most consistently repeatable patterns and gives you killer swing trade entries on a stock like DATS. And again, even if, you, let's say you had a different risk to reward and you didn't take profits at 1350, this thing might gap up. I mean, this thing could continue higher for quite some time. And if you've got a wider risk with a bigger goal, there'd be no reason to be spooked out of this. You wouldn't have to take profits at 1350 because maybe you're risking a wider stop. You know, maybe you're risking $3 a share because you've got a smaller position size and you're targeting more like $9. You're going to hold out for, you know, the low 20s, etc. So week open red to greens, the best morning pattern for swing trade entries. All right, episode 5. Next episode, we're going to talk about the best afternoon pattern. And oddly enough, you'd be surprised. I am going to use a different example in the next video. But the great thing about these patterns is they both work together. Quite frequently, great red to greens become amazing VWAP holds, which is that next pattern I'm gonna talk about. All right, everyone, head over to stocks2trade.com/free training to get access to everything, worksheets, watch list, the video archive, and we'll see you next time.